During that night, I left my body. And I found myself flying through this star-filled realm. Every time I tell this story, I just start smiling because it all comes back. But yeah, I was flying through this star-filled realm, and there were all these magnificent stars, orbs, all around me, and they were so welcoming, and it was like I was being paraded through, and I just, all I felt was everything a human ever wants to feel. Just acceptance and love and joy and being held. And all those things, all those negative things that we have about ourselves, they were gone. They were absolutely gone. Things like, you know, anger and resentment or spite or jealousy. In my opinion, those emotions do not travel with us. They stay here. They're tools for us to learn from. So anyway, I was flying through this star-filled realm, feeling absolutely ecstatic, like a cosmic orgasm. And it wasn't just an explosion. It was that was a full-time vibe. That is what we come from. We get glimpses of it here when we score the winning touchdown, or we get that job we wanted, or get the girl, you know, and all these victories, if you roll them all into one, times it by a million, that is your vibration. So yeah, we come down here to push against this really dense, harsh vibrations. And it's really a wonderful gift. It really is. I'm cruising along, and there was cosmic orgasm, just continuous. And oh, and I felt like I'd been released from a hot, dark closet. And I was this huge expanded cloud, a huge expanded balloon. It seemed like I went out forever. And the thing that I kept saying while I was flying along and I was enjoying everything, and I kept saying, how in the world did I believe I was this dude? It was such a crazy trick that I was this person, and I had all these good points and bad points and, you know, buttons, you know, we all have them, emotional buttons that are going to send me into whatever depression, and they were gone. All that was gone. All that was gone, and that remained with the person that was Bill Letson. And I had full knowledge of Bill Letson's entire life and knew all the details, and I didn't want anything to do with it. And I like him. He's a good guy, but I didn't want anything to do with it. The thought of going back was out of the question. I was well aware that my body was behind, and it was like a banana peel. What are you going to do with a banana peel? You're going to throw it away. And that's what it felt like. So I was flying along, and then all of a sudden I landed. I landed in a place that was solid. It had indirect lighting, and there were gurneys around, and there was equipment that was hanging from the ceiling. It was like a facility or a clinic or something. And right in front of me there were beings. There were these three short little hooded guys, and they looked exactly like those beings in the movie Communion. The guys I saw, they were in front of me. They had big smiles on their face, and they had these dark hoods and squatty little bodies. And one woman wrote to me, and she said, I was taken by these many times as a kid. And she goes, I called them the Warthog Men. The Warthog Men have come and taken me. And she said, when I saw that movie Communion, I dropped my popcorn. And says that they looked exactly like that. And I've gotten a number of emails from people saying, thank you for doing this, because I thought it was just mine. So anyway, yeah, they look kind of, I don't know, creepy is the right word, but they look different. But for me, they were sweethearts. And they were saying things like, how was it? What did you learn? What can you tell us? And I was extremely confused. All of a sudden, I was in this place with these beings from a cartoon, basically. And one of them stepped forward, and he took a long look at me. And then he turned to the other two, and he said, he doesn't remember us. And they all started giggling. And I was like, well, guys, I'm having a little trouble. All of a sudden, things are very strange from my perspective, you know. And I kind of remember you, but give me a little time. And they were giggling and bouncing around, and they were wonderful. And then there was this other guy, and he was sort of in charge. He was kind of in the background. He came forward, and he was this tall, wispy guy, and he had this incredible ecstatic smile. His eyes were open, his eyebrows were up, and he had this wonderful smile and laugh. And he was obviously in charge, but he was the best boss anybody could ever have. He wasn't, very strict at all. When he came forward towards me, My throat just tightened and my chest expanded, and I thought I was going to break down in uncontrollable crying from love. There was so much love pouring from this being that it was overwhelming. It was paralyzing. And I just loved it. I loved those guys. He was cool. There was some back and forth stuff. And every time I said something, he had this chuckle. I could feel it inside of me. He had this laugh. I got the impression that, you know, looking at it from a third person, that that was a relationship between a father and a child. And he loved me unconditionally. And at one point I said, I'm not going back there. No way, no how, ever. So I guess I got to move on from this place eventually. And so, you know, what's next? A review of my life? Would you guys like to get started with?